梦西哥，slow to anger and of great mercy. The Lord is good to all, and his tender mercies are over all his works. All right, that is a wonderful scripture, and I want to do the New Testament counterpart to that. 1 John 4. 1 John 4, if you would just turn to 1 John 4, verses 9 and 10. This is one of the most beautiful scriptures in the Bible, especially in the New Testament, 1 John 4:9, and this was manifested, the Lord of God told us, because that God sent his only begotten Son into the world that we might live through him. Herein is love, not that we love God, but that he loved us, and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sins. Amen. That is the second scripture. Flip back to Romans 8:32. This is a scripture that we constantly affirm. Psalms 8:32, he that spareth not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us what? All things. He that spared not his own son. Well, the scripture above that says, what shall we say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? And I tell you that if God be for us, that is perhaps the best definition of grace you can give. God being for us, God is for you. Amen. He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Amen. Want to make my point clear that God is basically a God of love. That is the perhaps most outstanding characterization that we can have of God. God is love. God is love. Amen. Sometimes people want to know what about the judgment side of God. Is God more apt to judge or than he is to love? But the scripture teaches us that God's strongest attribute is love. And love is the area that perhaps is the most effective in inspiring people to have faith and to believe God. It's the thing that causes the faith of people to rise mountain high. When we begin to emphasize that, to reflect on and prove it by the Bible, that God is a God that's full of compassion, that he's eager to pour out his blessings upon us in great profusion. Amen. That he delights in mercy. Amen. That his mercies are new every morning. Amen. So we want to challenge those that want to launch a healing ministry. Some of y'all got the testimonies. Amen. Just focus on the compassion side of God and let people's faith mountain high, and people can receive by faith. You don't have to have no special manifestation of God for God to heal. Amen. Just focus on his love, his compassion, his goodness, his eagerness. The Bible says he delighted in mercy. God is eager. He wants to do much more than you desire it to be done in your life. Amen. So I would challenge you to focus on God's love side rather than God's compassion, rather than God's judgment side. Okay, when from the scripture we know that when the Lord healed Job, that's probably one of the oldest cases of God's compassion shown in the Old Testament. I think that the story of Abimelech that we mentioned last Sunday was the first instance of divine healing manifested in the New Testament when God healed all of the wives of those servants whose wounds were closed as a result of Abraham giving over his wife to the king. And it was something that it was kind of deceitful, half-true, that he represented his wife as a sister, which was partial truth, but the king took her as his wife, and he didn't have sex with her because he was forbidden of God, but yet God sent judgment to that household because it was a sin against God. And all of the wounds of the women in that household servants amazed everybody. Their wounds were closed. Nobody could have babies. Amen. And then God's remedy for that was based on the blood of Jesus. The remedy has always been the blood. How many can say amen? Because this was the decision that the Trinity made even before man was created, that it would be a fall and the redemption would include Jesus becoming a lamb slain before the foundation of the world. And the redemption would be through his blood, even before the blood was shed. But the atonement typified the blood that would be shed, and because of the atonement typified the blood of Jesus, to show you how much power is in the blood, that God was able to bring healing even before Jesus was actually what? Became sin, and before he actually shed his blood, they could draw from the fact that Jesus would be the man. And God was under that, and God made a covenant with his people under the Old Covenant, in the Old Testament, that healing would be, amen, praise God, in a part of the redemptive package. Also, all of the Jehovah's, Jehovah's Sikkim, Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah, and some more, Nisi, and Jireh, all of these Jehovah's represent the provisions and blessings that God would grant to his people from the covenant based on the blood that would be shed. Amen. When Jesus actually became sin and took upon him the sin of the human race. To me, that was love. To me, that was compassion. And God told Abraham, God told Abimelech, the king, he said, you don't know who you're messing with. This man is a prophet. Amen. Although it was Abraham's fault, partially. Amen. But he commanded Abraham to pray for him. Pray for him and his household so that they would be healed. And Abraham prayed, and their wounds were opened. Amen. He was based on the blood. I mean, God doesn't do anything arbitrarily. He has to have a reason. And all of the miracles that you read about in the Old Testament of healings, deliverance, provisions, protection, God withholding judgment, and all of the things that God did to demonstrate his concern, his love, his compassion for his people. All of this was based on the blood. Based on the blood. Amen. We ought to be thanking God for the blood as he purchased us with his blood. Many times that doesn't register with us how important the blood. The Bible says we were not redeemed with corruptible things as silver and gold, but we were redeemed by the one precious blood of Jesus, who was a lamb. Oh, praise God. Who was a lamb slain before the foundation of the world. How many know that we were redeemed from the curse of the law because of the blood that Jesus shed? And actually, the provision style of healing, actually, it was actually manifested even before the blood actually was shed. Amen. The point, the atonement, Job offered an atonement. God told him to offer an atonement for his, amen, his sin, and also for his sickness and disease. 18 months, he was crowned with what? Sores from the top of his head to the bottom of his feet. I mean, he had gone from 225 down to 85 pounds. I mean, sores running everywhere, this pus and corruption issue out of his body. He was a sight to see. Nobody wanted to look upon him. People poked fun at it and said he needed to die because he had sinned and he had what, missed God. Hallelujah. And he was very rich, and amen, he lost all of his possessions, even his family, his children, and everything that he possessed. Amen. And they said that this came upon Job because he had what? Sin. Amen. But Job denied the fact that he had missed God. But the Bible says that things that Job wasn't aware of that was sin and that caused this condition to come upon him, he wasn't aware of it. But how many know a law is a law? And if you violate a law, whether you're aware of it or not, whether you believe in it or not, laws work. How many can say amen?
Amen.
You can say, well, I'm deep in the Lord. You can just hug up a slider, be real deep, go up on a 20-story building and jump down. You can see how much, amen, how spiritual you are. If I'm really spiritual, I'm deep, God is going to send the angels and he's going to what? Keep me from being hurt. Alright, if you fall and from a 20-story building, amen, more than likely you will be what? History. Amen. How many can say amen? Alright, because a law is a law, and law is without what? Respect on person. When you violate a law, there are consequences that you're going to experience. For that reason, hallelujah, Job had violated God's law because what? He had what? Consistently confessed what? Sickness and sin. I mean, not sickness but sin, but he always was concerned about what things that happened to him coming upon him. So we don't have to fear. Bible says, fear God not. Tell somebody, say, fear not. Be not dismayed. Amen. For I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will uphold you. I will help you. I will uphold you with the right hand of my righteousness. God doesn't want us to live a life in fear. And he doesn't want us to talk what? Negative. Amen. Always confessing what we ain't got. Amen. How bad we feel, how bad off we are, or what sickness or disease we got. We're not to confess the things that what? The devil put on us. Amen. You overcome by what? The blood of the Lamb and the word of your what? Confession. Amen. So we want to always be in agreement with what God says about us. How many can say amen?
Amen.
So God had to get Job back in faith. Amen. In order to get him back in faith, the atonement had to be what? Made. And repentance. Amen. He had to what? Repent to his friends. Amen. He had to repent. The Bible says he repented in sackcloth and ashes. Because he had what? Placed himself higher up, you know, above God almost. He's, I ain't seen God. Amen. Look, God, I'd like to meet you and could let you know. I ain't saying I'm perfect. I ain't never done nothing wrong. I have an old crack and bring it down. Amen. But humility can lift you up. Amen. Hallelujah. But Job submitted to the Lord and did what God told him to do. Amen. Prayed for his friends, and he would offer the atonement. Amen. Hallelujah. And he repented of his own sin in the areas that he had missed God. And the Bible says God turned. Oh my God. God turned the captivity of Job. Glory. God healed him. His flesh became like the flesh of a 16-year-old person. Amen. Boy, it's really amazing how God can do things like that. How many believe that God still can do stuff like that today?
Amen.
I said, well, if it's his will. All right. Well, God is the same yesterday. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and what? Forever. Amen. So that shows that in this scripture, James 5:11, it really gets to me every time I read it. It says that relating the experience that Job went through, and it mentions something like this. Let's see, she read it for me before, she's looking for it now. The Bible says, we've heard of the patience of Job.
Behold.
Yes.
We count him happy which endure.
Mm-hmm.
He has heard of the patience of Job.
Mm-hmm.
And has seen the end of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
That the Lord is very pitiful.
Mm-hmm.
And of tender mercy.
Mm-hmm.
But above all things.
Okay, that's a fact. The Lord is very pitiful. Some, when you said pitiful, people say, I said, oh, isn't she pitiful? They ain't even talking about that kind of pitiful. I mean, God is very tender. He's very, he's easily moved. The Bible says he's moved. He's touched with the feelings of our infirmities. In other words, he wants to help you so bad. But sometimes we get in positions where God's what? God's love can't, God's grace can't reach us. Sometimes people say, well, how can you get place yourself in a position where God's grace can't reach you? Amen. God is not going to violate his word, amen, to do anything for you if it's going to be a violation of his what? The Bible says the foundation of God stands what? Sure.
Yes.
God can't go back on his word, amen, to bless you when you don't meet his what? Meet his criteria. You have to bring yourself. How many said bring yourself? See, Job brought himself in a place where God's what? Grace, God's compassion could what could happen.
Amen.
How many can say amen?
Amen.
And when Job did what, well, there's a God side, God was side and a man was side to every battle, to every challenge that we have. Every victory, every battle. There's a godless side. There's something that you have to do, then there's something what God will what, has already done. He's already what? He's just waiting for you. God ain't slack concerning his promise. Hallelujah. But he's what? Long stuff. He's waiting for you to come in line so that these blessings can come upon you and what? Overtake you. How many can say that? The Bible says his eyes are running. Ooh, glory. I've got an old man like this. I still can run a little bit, see? Anyway, God's eyes are what? Running to and fro throughout the whole earth. Amen. He's looking for somebody that will place themselves in a position where his what? His mercy can reach them. Amen. How many know he's plenteous in mercy? He delighteth in mercy. Amen. The Bible, there's one chapter in Psalms. Somebody tell me where it is real quick. And the whole chapter is, oh, give thanks to the Lord for his good and his mercy and good for God. And the whole psalm, every verse is talking about what? Amen. The Lord is good and his mercy is good forever. Oh, the Lord is good. Amen. I want to make a case this morning that God ain't slack. Amen. God, the Bible says, amen, fear not, little flock, for it's the Father's good pleasure. Oh, praise. Oh, somebody says, so Father's good pleasure. To give us the kingdom. All right. The kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but it's what? Righteousness, peace, joy, and the Holy Ghost. Now, that scripture about Job, we have seen the end of the Lord. But that simply means that we have seen how God always comes through when we place ourselves in a position. Amen. Where his what? His love, his grace, and love can reach us. Amen. We have seen how God treats folks. That's how God treats folks. Hallelujah. How many like that? Amen. Like how God treats folks. Amen. The Bible says he's what? Amen. He's gracious. That means he's disposed to show favors. Oh, he loves the what? To show favors. Oh, what scripture is that? Amen. He daily loaded us. Amen. It could actually, amen, if God says, well, he daily bless us a little bit, to some degree. But he daily what? Loaded us. How many like that load on a daily basis? Lord, how many know he can crown you with loving kindness and tender mercies? Oh, his mercies are tender. Oh, hallelujah. His eyes run to and fro throughout the whole world. You see, those whose hearts are perfect before him. Amen. I just want you to get the right image of God. And once you get the right image of God, the right projection of God, then it's a lot easier amen, to hold fast your confession of faith without wavering, because you know, amen, Job saw the end of the Lord, right? All right, how many know that Abimelech household, they saw the end of the Lord, how he treated people? When you get back in what? Get back in land, amen, the healing comes, the blessings come. Hallelujah. How many know God is a blessing God? He's called the Father of mercies. Oh, the Father of mercies. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is what? Good. And his mercy endureth forever. How many can say amen? Let the redeemer of the Lord say so. How many can repeat this word? Amen. The Bible says you need to what? Say so. You need to what? Bless him. You need to let him know. This is a prerequisite for those blessings to come in reality in your life. Bless the Lord. Oh, praise. I'm just going to run down the side a little bit. I haven't seen it right in the book since we had praise and worship. I'm even doing praise and worship. Bless the Lord, all my soul. And all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Man, all these blessings God has loaded and blessed us. Amen. How can we just sit here just twiddle our thumbs and look wise and otherwise? Hallelujah. Like we lost our last, amen, best friend. Hallelujah. God ain't done nothing for me. Redemption don't mean much to me. But when the Bible says he has delivered us from what? The curse of the law. He has delivered us from the power of darkness. And he has translated us into the kingdom of his dear son. We have a lot, hallelujah, to praise God for all. So we need to learn how to bless and perfect praise. How many know it's a blessing perfecting your praise? Amen. God gives the Bible said good things to them that what? Amen. That seek him. To them that what? Praise him with all of their hearts. Hallelujah. God is a God of what? Love. A God of justice. God of blessings. God of hallelujah. The feelings of our infirmity. He wants to help us more than we can even realize. Amen. Israel's 2.5 million of them. Amen. Praise God. When they prayed to God, God heard their cry and saw the afflictions that they were having afflicted with over 400 years, and he came down and what? Rescued them. Amen. Praise God. That burning bush that Moses, that was a call of God for Moses was to go and deliver. Is that right?
Yes.
And then the last night, he sent the what? The death angel. That was the last plague that God had to what? Release. But that plague caused Israel to what? God told them to what? Amen. To kill a sacrifice. Make an atonement. Everybody kill a what? A sacrifice. And place the blood of that sacrifice on the what? The doorpost. And when I see that blood, I will what? Pass over. He has a way for his people. Hallelujah. The Bible says he brought them forth. The devil said, y'all never get out of Egypt. Well, they became rich. Egypt became rich on the backs of those poor people. But the Bible says God brought them forth with silver and gold. And there was not one left. Fever. Not one fever. 2.5 million people healed by the blood. How can they say that? Healed by the blood. That was before the blood was shed. If 2.5 million were healed by the blood, and for amen, and Israel for 450 years, amen, praise God, with the mother covenant based on the blood, was guaranteed healing, and they never had a doctor, they never had a hospital, they never had a medical attention. All they had was what? I am the Lord that healeth thee. And calves and
Hallelujah.
Sacrifices no more. We deal with the blood of Jesus. The Bible says we were bought with a price. Oh, glory. That's the reason why we are to glorify God in your body. Again. God said, bless the Lord, all my soul. See, when you come and say, all these blessings, all the things in yours, I bless you with every spiritual blessing. I've given you everything, everything since I like it. Somebody said, where are these blessings? Well, you know, God has already made these blessings, Lord. These blessings accessible to you.
Thank you, Lord.
And he's waiting for you to bless him. That's the crap. That's the thing that we always talk about. Faith is what? Praising God for what you believe. What he has done before you get it. Before you get it. Can you do it before you get it? I'm not saying, well, I'm good at doing it after I get it. That's not the way faith works. Just sit, looking like Abraham, a calf looking at a new gate. The Bible says, if you bless it with all that you have, I'll forgive all your sins. That means what? I'll get every hindrance, every barrier out of your way for the healing of the blessing you're seeking to come on you. Praising God will get what? Will clear the land. Will be what? Loaded.
Yes.
I believe that will be loaded. He will what? Daily loaded us.
Hallelujah.
I don't believe money, hallelujah, would be an issue anymore. Hallelujah. Say amen. The Bible said God has what? Pleasure.
Yes.
In the prosperity of his servants. You know, I wish to know all things that he will prosper and be in health.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
Even as
hallelujah.
Your soul prosper. He wants to bless you real bad. He wants you to position yourself with a blessing and get it to you without him violating his divine word principles. Hallelujah. And blessing God is the best way to get. You don't have to know how anything to bless the Lord. The Bible says if we delight ourselves in the Lord, he will give us the possession of our heart. How much he wants to do it. Amen. Hallelujah.
He
loves us. soul of my heart shall. You in the first one was going to bring. Hallelujah. The Bible says he was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace is upon him. And by his stripes we are what? It's his past tense. It's past tense. Hallelujah. The Bible says we reign in this life. How can they say I reign?
I'm
in charge. The devil's under my feet. I have power and authority over everything that the devil sends my way. Greater is he. Oh, I can't understand. Greater is he that is in me. See, the Bible says that we are saved by his life. You gotta have some life. That's how God's work. Hallelujah. The Bible says the spirit of the law of life in Christ soul after that. You have to get your spirit. Amen. Tune up. I'm going to say I need a tune up. Spiritual tune up. Everybody say a spiritual tune up is what I need. That means when you get tuned up with what? Praise God. Meditate on the word. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the sea. The name of the Lord is the new one. That's how you get your tune up. Amen. Praise God. Bless the Lord with all that you have. Us with his blood. Glorify God in your heart. All with the price. You all with the price of his blood. He wants you to walk. Glorify him. Glorify him. And as you begin to glorify him, hallelujah, just like Israel. Hallelujah. Amen. When they were bitten by fiery serpents, hallelujah, because of that murmuring and complaining, they had to what? Get back in line. Moses what offered up an altar. And he raised that brazen serpent, put it up on a pole. How many can say amen?
Amen.
And he says, many of you that will look, you'll live.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. It was just, come on. It wasn't just a brazen serpent that caused that healing to come. It was the blood. It was that redemption. Hey! Amen. That serpent prefigured what the redemption that will be in Christ. And they were under the old covenant. Jesus had even offered it yet. But yet, when they looked, when they looked, how many of you look today? Hallelujah, hallelujah. When you look, when I said look, that means what? You got to what? You got to put forth some effort. You got to praise God. You get up, you know, most of y'all that suffer from some, anyway, you get up and shout in 5 minutes, probably all that. All you need to do is what? Basically, they can start praising the Lord like you're crazy.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Hallelujah.
See, God wants it more than you want it.
Thank you.
And it's not easy, it's not hard. It's not hard to get what he got. What he has already what, given you.
Yes.
He's trying to get something, get him up, work up something. And he's already what? Blessed. Look, healing is already in this place.
Yes. Thank you.
scriptures I can see. Why everybody would back off. But since you had to pray 24 hours before God's blessing would be real, I can see why you wouldn't have any checkers. You have one or two. Everybody sitting under you. Amen. But he makes it so easy. He said, if you just delight yourself in me.
Hallelujah.
Isn't that simple? If you just delight yourself in the Lord of the Lord, he said, I'll give you what? You just have to have it. Just delight. In other words, get real happy. Get real happy. Get full of joy. With joy. You draw water out of the wells of salvation. Amen. The main thing. Amen. You got to have the right concept of how good God is. Amen. If you really want to find out how good it is, just read of Matthew, Mark, Luke, John. Boy, he healed everybody that came, every sickness, every disease, whether people asked him or not, as many as touched him. Amen. People have been waiting for years, amen, to get healed. He just asked them, you want to be whole? I mean, that shows that what? How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with what? The Holy Ghost and power who went about doing good, healing all of those that were oppressed of the devil. But God was with it. Jesus said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me. Everybody can say, he has anointed me. He's anointed you to get healed. Now, I'm anointed to get healed. I'm anointed to get blessed. I'm anointed to prosper. Because of the Spirit of the Lord. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He has what? Anointed me. How many know the Holy Ghost is there to anoint you? That's the exceeding greatness of it. That's all the power that God has. It's the power of the Holy Ghost. And you got that of his soul that you have received. That's the Holy Ghost. Grace upon grace. And it's not talking about grace. Riches of grace. Exceeded grace. Great grace. Amen. Hallelujah. Abounded grace. Through the abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness, we are to reign. Defeat Satan on every hand. Number two. Closing down. We have to know who we are. Amen. We are blessed. We are blessed. Work is already done. Amen. If the Son sets you free, you should be what? Free and free. If the Word, the Spirit of the law of life in Christ Jesus, amen, makes you free, you have to know who you are. How many can say, I know who I am? I'm not underneath, I'm not below, I'm above, I'm not the tail, I'm the head. Hey! Hallelujah! And I want Christ as what? I was quick. Up to sit with him in heavenly places. Amen. Just visualize you sit with Christ in his right hand. Anybody can see that? You can raise up to sit with him. We are not there, we are what? We are wrong. The devil is under our feet. More than conqueror. I dare you to say that, more than conqueror. Send me the hope of God. I can do. Oh, he's in Christ. That's what we say. Greater is he that is looking at me. Let me redeem you when the Lord says so. How many will say so? You have to know the enemy. You have to know the enemy. I know that he's what? He's defeated. Yes. I know I've been delivered from the power of what? Satan. Yes. I know that he is as a roaring lion, going to and fro, trying to what? Seek whom he may devour.
Yes.
But the Bible says, I can what? Resist him.
Yes.
If I submit to God, I can what? Resist him. You have to know. Amen. Praise God. Your enemy. And know that you have power and authority.
Yes. Yes.
How many say I have power and authority? And my words count. Jesus said, I will create the fruit of your lips. Whosoever shall say to the
you believe you're a devil master, raise your hands. I'm a devil master.
Amen.
All right, you may take your seat. Amen. Praise God.
Praise God. All right. I want to encourage all of those that are standing for your healing to read the prayers in the confession book. And after you read the confession, I believe it was page 37 through 39. And all of that will help to get you into a place where your faith is activated. And see, God has to have, you know, because you're saved or delivered by His life. The more joy, the more enthusiasm, and the more excited you get about His Word, then the quicker you will begin to see the manifestation. Amen. And there are things that you need to be saying until the manifestation comes, because that's the thing designed to keep you real happy, to keep you optimistic. The Bible said that we become partakers of Christ if we hold fast our confidence, steadfast all the way to the end, until the manifestation comes. And the best way to do it is to what? Is to constantly confess what you're believing for and to praise God for the what? The end results of what you're desiring from the Lord. Yeah. How many can say amen?
Amen?
Hallelujah. Those that I didn't pray for last week, we anointed everybody with oil that was believing God for healing. If you weren't here in on that, we want to just lay hands on you. Amen. Praise God. And we will take care of that today if you want. The prayer of faith shall save the sick. Call for the elders of the church and anoint them with what? Oil? In the name of the Lord and the prayer faith. How many can say the prayer faith? The prayer faith will what? Save the sick. And the Lord shall what? Raise them up. How many can say amen? Amen. The prayer of faith will work. He worked for 300 years until they got into paganism after Jesus had actually consummated our redemption. That's all that they had for 300 years. Amen. Was the prayer of faith. So we know that healing from God actually has to work. That's all they had, the prayer of faith. Amen. Elders laid hands upon people that were seekers. And the prayer of faith saved the sick. And the Lord would raise them up.
Yeah.
Hallelujah! Everybody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
All right. All right. Praise it. Now unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we can think or ask, according to the power that worketh in us. To the only wise God be glory, honor, dominion, and power, both now and forever. Everybody say together. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Amen. Okay.